Both the WPI as well as CPI have been trending down, and it is well known fact that they will trend lower further, and market participants expect WPI and CPI to head lower in the first half of the financial year and then gradually start heading higher. So based on our calculations, we expect WPI to average between 5.5% to 6% in the financial year 2014. So based on that, we believe that the RBI will have little more headroom to look at reducing rates further. Having said that, the RBI will also focus on the current account deficit as well as the outcome of the monsoon before deciding which way to cut rates. So the chances are that the RBI may not look to cut rates in June, but by July definitely we expect the RBI to cut rates. We believe that the interest rates are generally going to trend lower in the first half of the financial year, and second half of the financial year is slightly trickier given the fact that by that point of time your inflation base effect will also start wearing off and inflation will start trending higher. We will also have the outcome of the monsoon in front of us, and also that by that point of time we will also come to know the financial status of the Government of India vis-a-vis the budgetary expectations. So we expect interest rates to remain range bound with a declining bias in the first half, and the second half will be based on the facts at that point of time. But generally, yes, I agree that the interest rates are likely to remain subdued from here. The current account deficit for FY13 was quite high, about 5.1%. We expect the current account deficit to be closer to 4.5% in FY14. Now, on one hand, while the gold, which was part of the partly the reason for higher current account deficit, will moderate in 2014, yes, but the larger equation is crude oil, and as you know that India's requirement of crude oil is inelastic. That means whatever the price is, the import for crude is likely to remain, and India imports roughly about 1/3 of the total import is oil. So from that perspective, I believe that crude oil will be the primary driver for the current account deficit in 2014, and we expect crude oil prices to remain range bound with a declining bias. So based on that, I think we need to pay more attention to crude and its demand rather than gold in 2014. With regards to the fiscal deficit, I think it's premature right now. The bulk of the data clarity will happen in the second half. And at that point of time, I think, as I mentioned to you, that your inflation effect will also wear off. You will have clarity on the monsoon. And being a pre-election year, the government's mood at that point of time, whether to spend more money in order to revive economic growth vis-a-vis what is the revenue streams at that point of time, will give us more clarity. But we expect the government to stick to the fiscal deficit forecast of 4.8. I think the whole market is fixated on the RBI's prospects of cutting rates. What we have seen so far this year is that the RBI has reduced interest rates by 75 basis points so far on the repo rate, right? But that has not translated into a reduction in loan rates. And for that, I think banks have made it very clear that the systemic liquidity continues to remain tight. So it is not as much of the RBI's rate cutting cycle, but it's a liquidity issue. So even if the RBI doesn't decide to cut rates going forward, but if the systemic liquidity in the banking system improves and from the deficit it turns positive, then you will immediately see the short-term interest rates falling by about 75 to 80 basis points, and the yield curve, which is extremely flat right now, will start turning steeper, and that will possibly be the harbinger of economic growth going forward. One way of accessing more systemic liquidity is by way of cutting CRR. That's number one. Second thing is by way of doing a lot of open market operations, bond purchases. The third thing is the government spending. I think the government is sitting on a lot of cash surplus. Now, if the government starts spending money, then the money will start coming back into the banking system, and then that will flood the liquidity. And the fourth being the most important one is the FII inflow. So if the FIIs decide to come to the RBI and says, take my $1 billion and give me equivalent amount of money, so that way you can have injection of liquidity in the banking system. We believe that this year is going to be a year of the fixed income, and we could possibly see investors benefiting from the declining interest rate scenario. And I think investors should consider putting money in duration product based on their risk appetite. But having said that, what is important to keep in mind is that in this scenario, the global financial markets are extremely volatile and situation could suddenly change in a very short time period. So investing in duration funds, which in turn invest in very high quality liquid assets, is very important so that the fund will have enough flexibility to change their asset allocation should there be a need. But for the foreseeable future, that is between 6 months to 9 months, I believe that duration funds should do well.
Mutual fund investments are subject to market risks. Read all scheme-related documents carefully.